Descript is able to recognize your words even though on the audio there might be crosstalk. If you have multiple speakers on the same recording, the same track, it's sometimes possible for Descript, most of the time, it's possible for Descript to recognize the audio and to transcribe the persons properly. However, if the crosstalk is too long, maybe several seconds, it's going to be hard to distinguish, and then you're going to be having a hard time separating the transcript from one person to another, and Descript is going to have some alignment problems because both people talking over each other. So that's a bit difficult. But if you have multiple tracks and you synchronize them in a sequence on two tracks, for example, two speakers, it is easier to fix crosstalk this way because you can go to the individual track and either delete, mute, or move the speech from that region where it's a bit more clear of the other person so that you can eliminate the crosstalk and be able to edit. So let's have a look at this workflow. I have a composition here created from two videos and two audios. So there's two people talking, and it's quite easy to spot crosstalk if you have identified the speakers. If you look on the timeline, just increase the height a little bit, you can see that Descript will give a different color to every person. So now in the script, I have my name in red and Chris's name in green. So the same thing happens on the timeline. You can see our individual waveforms colored differently. So that's because that is a sequence down there in the timeline that I've used to create this composition from. If we look in the media bin at the top, there is a sequence and there is two sequences here. One of them is both speakers. This is my sequence that I've used down here to create this composition. The way to go there, look, you see, this is actually quite easy to spot crosstalk because both of our waveforms are appearing at the same time. So my red one and Chris's green ones, they play at the same time. And if I play this, you're going to hear that we do actually crosstalk here.
Podcast episode.
Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
So there is your crosstalk. How can we solve this? Well, it's quite easy. When you are down here in the timeline or also in your text, you can right click and say edit sequence. That's going to take you to the sequence that you used when you align all the files to create this composition. So in this case, it's going to take me right here. And here I can see the tracks individually. And of course, you can see Chris is talking here and I'm down there. But we do have this gap here between us. So one way to fix this is, okay, this is a problem if you have video, because you need to move both the audio and the video. But if the video is part of the audio track, so they're the same file, it's quite easy because you can actually go and make a cut right there. And this applies to audio as well. You can make a cut using the blade tool, press B for the blade tool, and you can go here and click to make a cut and make another cut after. So now press A to switch to the selector tool. By the way, if you don't like keyboard shortcuts, you can find these tools here on the top right, select tool. And now with the selection tool, I can actually make some room on the timeline here and grab this clip and move it like that. And if you notice down there below, the waveform moves on the audio on the composition itself too. So I can actually push this forward even more like that. And the only downside to this is, look, if you restore that from the left, you're bringing it back. So the only downside to this, when you're doing this on video material, you're going to cut the video too. So it may not be what you want, but on audio workflows, you don't care if the speech is a bit later. So watch this.
Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
So now there's no more crosstalk, and this works better in audio. As I said, if I close this sequence right now and I look down there, you see Chris's waveform, the green one, does not overlap mine anymore. So.
How are you? Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
So one workaround here, if you're working with video and you had to move that away to get rid of the crosstalk, you could potentially put the other speaker on the screen while the other person is on a black screen because you moved them. So that could be here Look, if I go here, I'm going to move my video full screen, potentially even create a scene right there. I'm going to make a scene before Chris is talking. Press slash and another one here with me. So there we go. This is me now in this scene. I'm going to be full screen. And I'm going to remove Chris's video from that portion right there. So let's see what happens now.
Hey, Chris, welcome to the show, to my fake podcast episode. How are you doing? Hey, I am wonderful.
So now we've gone into the other scene, and if I choose so, I can take Chris and put him full screen on this other scene right there. I don't have to delete my video. It's behind it. So watch this when the scene changes.
Hey, I am wonderful for having me.
So now you can create another scene and put both of us side by side. So that's one way to work around the crosstalk in this particular case where you have video. As I said, if you have audio, you don't worry about this. And another thing you can do with audio is if you don't care for that person's, maybe some people like to approve as you talk. So either the host or the guest, you're talking and then they approve you, like they say, yeah, okay, yeah, sure. All those words, maybe you don't want to leave them in there, but it's hard to remove from the script maybe because you don't want to cut everything else. So that way you can go in the composition again. So let me show you here. I've got these black waveforms. These ones are actually laughter or something.
Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
So that's laughter. The black waveform means that the script hasn't identified or assigned that waveform to a speaker, which makes it background noise, laughter, non-speech content. So again, right-click in here and go to Edit Sequence. And you see this one here, it's on my track. I'm the one laughing around there. So I can again use the Range tool. So check this out. Press R for the Range tool. You can find it here, by the way, as well, Range. And you can make a selection on my track here, the one that I've got the black waveforms with the laughing. Okay, and now delete or backspace on the Mac, and I have removed all of that. I've also removed the video, you know, so just so you know, but I don't care really because on that portion, Chris is on the screen, as you know. By the way, if I actually want some of my video is gone, I can bring that back right there, you see. Control mouse wheel will zoom you in. So then I don't want to remove my video, although Chris is showing there, but I don't want to hear this. Well, that's another way to do it, is you use the blade tool, make a cut in that clip right there, and again, click on it with the select tool, press A to select this particular clip. And you see it's video there with audio, but I don't want to listen to it. I don't want to hear it. So I can click on it. Just need to make sure that I'm not muting the whole track. You see here, this is the whole track. You need to go up here to that clip. By the way, this is the one that's selected. You see it, it's got a bit of a different gray background. And you can click on this option. And right here, you've got the audio just for that particular chunk of the clip. And click mute right there. So that's now zero minus infinity decibels. So you see my video is still on, but you should not hear me laughing. Let's see.
Hey, I am wonderful.
Okay, and we go out of here, and now it should all be good and clean.
Episode, how are you today? Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Great. This is my first test of...
Okay, great. Let's put it back to a new scene right here in which we are both on the screen side by side like this. So now we're back to a full side-by-side scene. So this is what happens in that region there.
How are you today?
Hey, I am wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Great. This is my first test of...
So we have resolved the crosstalk and we have successfully navigated around not having black video where I made the deletions by either sliding the video forward and backward, filling the screen with the person that's actually showing and talking, and also by muting a particular piece of the clip. That's another way to get rid of crosstalk on a single track. And also, what I do with this is I usually have some clients who send me audio files with mic bleed, which means both people, you can hear them on both tracks. And that's usually a problem for Descript because it thinks that everybody's saying the same things twice. So that means you need to go in and clean that up. If you're not cleaning the mic bleed in a different program like Audition or Audacity, you can clean it up in here by making these cuts. So if you have any problems with that, where the transcript is polluted with extra words that you shouldn't have there, then you can go and kind of select with the range tool, delete those parts from the sequence, from the appropriate track, and then the other track will be free to play on its own with the sound. But if you have video, by the way, you could actually clean that up by just separating the video from the audio and just dealing with the audio, by the way. So let me show you how that is done. If you right-click in the timeline again and go to Edit Sequence, you can see here that I have two tracks, and both of them have audio and video. But I don't want to worry about the video all the time. Maybe I want to silence a lot of portions, but I don't want to touch the video. So I can actually right-click and say Detach Audio. Detaching audio will move the audio to a separate track and keep the video on its own track. Now, you probably want to do this before you start making cuts in your videos, because then you're going to have to do it for all of them. Look at this. See, I am detaching audio. And now because I didn't have other cuts, it's now detached the whole thing. But you probably ideally want to do this before, when you start editing, you create your sequence, you drop your videos and audios, and then if you need to split the video from the audio, you do it right then, and then you start editing, which means you need to leave your tracks. Don't slide them left and right, keep them in sync. But that actually gives you now the flexibility to clean up the audio without worrying about deleting video from it, right? So if I go in here, you see I have this piece of noise here. Look, I've got a little noise in there that I want to remove. That's my video, but I use the range tool, R, and I can just go do this on the audio file. In fact, I'm going to silence the whole gap right there, delete. So now look, video is unaffected. The audio is silent for that portion that I removed. And if you change your mind, by the way, we've covered this, you can go back and restore by pulling the end of the clip and filling the gap back again with the missing audio. So that's how you do it. That's how you resolve crosstalk, individual edits on audio in the sequence. You do need a sequence for this, and you do need separate video or audio streams for every speaker, which is recommended to do. And if you're doing recordings in Zoom, Zoom does have an option to record separate audio for every speaker. So look that up.